Hi everyone, this is Tanner here, and today I'm going to be reacting to my Super Mario Galaxy 3 YouTube short I made. It has done very well, so thank you for that. And I basically said if Super Mario Galaxy 3 were to be made, what type of galaxy should appear? So I'm going to be reading your responses and just kind of saying my thoughts here. We got a couple of comments. But yeah, I'm going to be doing more of these YouTube shorts and, you know, comment because I'll be going through them. Alrighty, Hoja Discord said they can't make a third one. How they continue the I am Mr. K Sparkle. I don't know what that is. I feel like that's a reference to something. You know, the thing with Mario Galaxy is that the first two, the second one is very similar to the first, so I don't know what that is. I don't know if that's like a reference to like a content creator. Probably a joke, but I'll just say, you know, if you need the term, Mario Odyssey was really great, so they could do that. This is probably something I'm missing, then I probably look a bit stupid here. Wolf Puppy Simba says, since they added a throwback to Mario 64 of Womp's Fortress, they should do one for either Sunshine or another Mario 64 Galaxy. Yeah, so it's called, I think, the Throwback Galaxy from Mario Galaxy 2, and the galaxy was pretty much Womp's Fortress. I love that idea. I think Bomb Bomb Battlefield would be really cool to see. I love Bomb Bomb Battlefield, one of my favorite personal 3D Mario stages of all time. I think just it's such a unique idea of going on in this battlefield with bomb bombs. So you could do that. I'm blanking on the name to Iceland from Mario 64. Oh my gosh. The one where you race a penguin, the snowman. It's escaping my mind. I love the Lava Land as well with all the bullies and the fire. Lethal Lava Land, there we go. So yeah, there's a lot of ways to go. And then Sunshine, you know, I love personally. I think it's an excellent game. And, you know, Rico Harbor or, you know, would be great, I think. I think you could do a lot with that. Well, they kind of did that, actually. They did, like, a Sunshine throwback as well. Peanut Park, I think, would be a lot of fun. So let's just respond here. So I'll say I agree. For 64, they could do Lethal Lava Land or Bomb Battlefield. And for Sunshine, they could do... How about Noki Bay? Noki. I'm going to make sure I'm spawning that right. Mario Sunshine Noki Bay. Noki, okay, was with a K, just to make sure. Noki Bay, that's a really fun area. Or Kina Park. If you look at Noki Bay here, I'm recording me responding because I want to make sure that, you know, I do actually respond. I'm not just saying this. I actually am going through the comments. But yeah, Noki Bay here. I don't know why I thought it was with a C. The pasta, right, is with a C, I think. But yeah, I mean, it looks really awesome. I love the colors of it. It has this almost ruins feel. And Mario Galaxy, I think you could do a lot with that platforming. Very difficult area, but a very fun one. My favorite one was the eel. We always have to clean his teeth. Great level and boss fight. Look at that design. Pretty scary. So let's go on to the next one. The cat eye. Okay, I don't know what this is referencing, but like maybe a cat? I don't know, but Froggy Boy, that's an interesting one. That is a very interesting one. Interesting idea. I feel like, let's see, the cat eye. Is that Mario reference? Is this like another thing? Oh, they mean like, oh, you know, do they mean like the Mario cat power up? Could be interesting. I like this idea. They could even... Oh, not that. They could even bring back the Super Bell. Which is cool. I love that power-up. So, there we go. One thing I wanted from a Galaxy game was to have planets that were kind of like the beginning / tutorial area of each game. Every planet is like 5 meters in diameter, so I'd love ginormous planets in a galaxy that could have like 5 minutes to circle around. Maybe give some sort of an item like the dash pebble to get around faster. I love this. X-Skull? Hope I'm pronouncing that right. Yeah. So I know Because, like, in Mario Galaxy 1, there's, like, a tutorial with some small planets. So I get what you mean. But I would love that, where you have to go around. It takes 5 minutes. And then, again, going back to Mario Odyssey, one thing about Odyssey that was so great is that it took a while to explore the kingdoms. You know? You would have to use, like, you know, there's that, like, Sphinx thing, that desert land in Odyssey. Point is, it took a while to travel. And Nintendo's, I think, gotten more friendly with travel, like Breath of the Wild. You know, we have, you know, a horse you can use and things of that nature. So I definitely love that idea. I think that would be great with exploration. You could use a dash pepper or something new. Maybe Yoshi? But that's an excellent idea because you can actually have the planets feel huge. Don't say, I love this idea. Could make the planets actually feel big and could maybe even use Yoshi or a new power up to travel. Great stuff. Yeah, I think that's really cool if they do that. Because Mario Galaxy is all about exploration, so that's awesome. See, that's the thing. Going back to that first comment is how they have, you know, I think a lot of people would be concerned about how would you do the magic of the first two. Well, that would be basically going bigger, I think. And I think you can do that with that. Okay, so cool stuff. I think we have one or two more. Okay, so we have Super Alejandro Bros says there are Super Mario Galaxy sufficient 100%. It's not 100% yet, so I hate to break it. But I will say is that I could see something in this E3. I do think it'll be coming soon because it's been rumored for a while. But I could see something at E3 this year. I don't know. I feel like, you know, Nintendo knows people love Mario 3D games. You know, they did have Odyssey. It was a very fan-pleasing game. I could 110% see them doing Galaxy 3. I don't know. I just feel like that they did the 3D Mario All-Stars thing a while back. And I like the game a lot, personally. I do. But I know a lot of people did not. And a lot of people, like, we want the game's HD or remake. So, hopefully we will get something at this year's E3. So yeah, I just want you all to know, I actually do respond to the comments. Noob says, Dark Cavern Galaxy, 5 stars to correct. Collect. Yeah, that's great. Reminds me of the Deep Dark Galaxy from Mario Galaxy 1. That was a lot of fun. Had some spooky elements in there, so that would be nice. Yeah. Mario has always been in caves. He's always been out in the ground areas ever since the original Mario Bros. Makes sense. Even the Mario Bros. Arcade game, he was in, like, a sewer, which is kind of like a dark cave-like place. Let's see the Deep Dark Galaxy here. I wanna look at this, because this was always a fun one in the first game. You had the Camilla boss fight there. You got to race a shark. Love that image. Guppy Oval looked very cool. So yeah, they could do that. Great idea. Great idea. Could be a lot of fun. Alright, so that'll do it here, everyone, for this video. That was a lot of fun. I'll just go through some of my other shorts here to see if any other people responded. Let's see. Mike, do we have any comments here? We have one from Bram McGree. Nice stuff. I think we had a bit on the Super Mario Bros. Thing, Super Mario World. One. Mario Kart Double Dash? Nope. Mario Party, Mario Kart, let's see. Nope. The most underrated Mario game. What do people say here? My favorite character, Princess Peach, with a floating ability. Yes. I agree. That was very fun to have in Super Mario Bros. 2 USA. Great stuff there. What? New? I don't know what this guy's trying to say, Dijon K. A couple of Jills said yes. I thought it was like new Super Mario Bros. I don't know. They bought the game from someone else and just reskinned it very, very lightly. Look up Doki Doki Panic, yes. Not the dude, but okay. I do know that. okay, getting called out here. I do know about that, that they did reskin it. Still think it's underrated. It's a bit weird, I know that. I'll say, yes, I know about the Doki Doki Panic thing. However, I still think it is a very fun one-off type of Mario game, even though the way it got made is very odd. Yeah. So, that is the thing with Mario Bros. 2, is that the way it got made is very weird, but yeah, I like that. And that guy's like, we all know. You know? Alright. Let's see. Oh, I thought this was mine. I'm like, whoa, what is that? I'm like, I did not upload a YouTube short with someone singing. And let's go to the next one. Okay. We'll go with these two and then call it a video. Let's go with Mario Bros. 3 and Mario World. Not even an argument. They're literally from different gaming generations. I get that. They're different, but hey, still fun to compare. I do understand that, though. I do get that completely. Super Mario World. W? Do they mean world? I think they did. Hey, Andrew! Super Mario World, of course. Yes, the right answer, Andrew. Hey, nice to see you, Andrew. Also, great choice. How's it? Hope all is well, Andrew, if you're watching this. But yeah, I can see why you can think it's a bit of an unfair comparison. It's like saying, though, like, what's better, Star Wars, The Avengers, or different years, but if you're not a fan of the comparison, that is okay. And then, the last one here. Oh, no one commented. Alright. But yeah, we went through that. Did we get anyone on the power-up video? No. Okay, just wanted to make sure. Alrighty, everyone. Well, I'll be reacting to the Koopaling ones. Creator Koopaling, who's the best? Gonna be reading off your comments. I'm interested to see what the majority of people say. I'm guessing we might get a couple Larry, maybe Ludwigs. It's gonna be very interesting to see. Hope everyone, though, has a great day and take care.